Blessed is our God, always now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
O Lord, hear my prayer with your dear supplications and your truth. Hear me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment with your servant, for in your sight no one is justified. For the enemy has persecuted my soul, yet crushed my life to the ground. Yet may me dwell in darkness, that there is a bond in death. My spirit is ever bound within me. My heart within me is distressed. I remember the days of old, meditated in all your works. I pondered on the work of your hands. For it has spread out my hands to you, my soul longs for you at the first man. Hear me quickly, O Lord, my spirit fails. Do not turn away. Turn your face away from me, lest I be left out to the depths of the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, for in you I put my trust. I do not know the Lord, the way in which I should walk, for I have lifted up my soul to you. Rescue me, Lord, from my enemies. To you have I felt for refuge. Take me to your will, for you are my God. Your good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. For your name's sake, O Lord, we shall keep me in righteousness. You shall bring my soul out of trouble, and in your mercy you shall utterly destroy my enemies. And you shall destroy all those who afflict my soul, for I am your servant.
God is the Lord who has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord,
God,
upon his holy name.
Deus qui Deus, que et man enemy, and lo imagos or comenos, and an oma quidiu. All the nations have surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord I am overcome them. God is the Lord who has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
The
second
of the Lord is one
corner of us. Deus qui Deus, que et man enemy, and lo imagos or comenos, to the Theotokos, let us run down with certainty, as sinners and holy ones, let us fall down in repentance, crying from the depths of our souls, Lady, come and help us, have compassion upon us, hasten now, for we are lost in the host of our errors. Do not turn your servants away, for you alone are a hope to us.
Stresses and dangers deliver me.
Destroy the terror of sin.
conduct a pious and orthodox Christian those residing within this community and city. Members, council members, contributors, we love those members, benefactors of this holy church. God, whose names are being commemorated throughout this paroquial service, for those that we perfectly call to mind at this time, for those here present who await your great and abundant mercy. For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, to you we ascribe glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Offer a prayer and almost unshakable, a merciful spring and shelter of all. Theotokos, our Lady, come to us and from all dangers now deliver us.
The only protection which leads you
us. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Still the darkest of passions, calm the sea of errors in your great peacefulness. It was you who bore the guiding Lord, and you who are the blessed bride of God. Yeah, so successor to our holy maker of faith, Lord. Please reject not the prayerful cries of those who are in sin. Instead, come to us, for you are good. Your loving help bring unto us who are crying in faith to you. Hasten to intercede and speed not to supplicate as a prince for all time. or most related to the office and ever remarried by the power of the precious and life and cause protection of the honorable by those powers of heaven, sanctification of the glorious prophet and forerunner of the Baptist, the holy glorious appearance of the apostles and the fathers and the saints, the great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, faith of the great Greek theologian and John Chrysostom, Thanasis and Cyrodiil, merciful patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Myra, Spiro, Bishop of Demetrius, Ignatius of Cadopolis, the wonder workers, the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George, victorious, Demetrius, the Rephaelian, Peter, the recruit, Peter, the commander, the holy, higher martyrs, the novelist, the Fabius, the holy, glorious, the grand martyrs, the Bible, God, the Son of God, the holy, righteous ancestors, God, Joachim, and Anna, Obadiah, the prophet, Barlaam, Caesarea, Antimus, Palladius, Christopher, Phoenia, and the chosen martyrs, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints, we beseech you, O merciful Lord, your sinners who pray to you, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Truly the birth giver of our Lord, with choirs and body, the angels, you do even. God, all the power of the Holy Spirit, to live in the very heart of the city and of all cities. towns of pestilence, famine, earthquake, flood, fire, and sword, from invasion of enemies, civil war, accidental death. For his mercy, he will be kind to and treat us every good God who loves all people, and he may turn away and scatter all wrath and disease and against us, and deliver us from his intended justified chastisement and have mercy on us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is in our midst. It is difficult when we understand such hatred that is around the world. It's difficult to not be affected by it. It's difficult to know that people can sacrifice themselves to murder and kill others, and that they consider this to be a good thing, a zealous thing that they are doing for God, for the God that they serve, and for a very hateful cause, and a very hateful. It's hard because when we read the stories of the martyrs, it is not this story that we read. In the stories of the martyrs, they are always the sacrifice. They are not asking for the sacrifice of others. Even in the story who we commemorate on the calendar day of the 18th, with the story of Roman Rus, he had no way of knowing that child would be sacrificed in his stead. He thought for sure it would have been him. It would have been he that was sacrificed. But it is always a willingness of martyr. And even when that child was being martyred, he was comforting those around him, saying, "It doesn't hurt." It's how God blesses those people who make that commitment to him. But there is no self-sacrifice or suicidal mission in any Christian denomination, except a very bad one, that would require the murder of other individuals. It just doesn't exist. And when we see the stories of those saints, I mean, Saint Barlaam of Caesarea, he's another one of those light incense to the idol stories. It was his time. It was his turn. And they brought him up. They gave him the incense. They said, "Throw it down." He said, "Forget it. I'm not doing that." You know, he threw it away. You know, he wasn't sitting there wishing the death. Saint Paraskevi,
right? She wasn't wishing the death of anyone. In fact, when the prefect got blinded, what did she do? She prayed for his sight. And it was restored. This is the person that was killing her. Do we have anyone killing us in our lives? No. We have a few people in our lives that maybe, you know, drive us crazy on a day-to-day basis. But nothing like this. Nothing like this. And St. Barlaamus, he's in Rio, when it came time, he who's member we commemorate today, when it came time and they said, light the incense, and he cast the incense away, they said, oh, you'll light it. We'll make sure you do it. Whether what was the saying, by hook or by crook, right? They put the incense in his hand and forcibly placed his hand over the flame. So as if he himself wouldn't, by accident, drop the incense, perhaps the flame would burn up so tightly that he would jump, and that the incense would burn off. And they would have accepted it, saying that they got it. But when they did this, they placed it in his hand, and they placed his hand over the fire. What did he do? No way. Till it hurt him so badly that his burnt hand, in that state, scorched his hand, and he gave his soul up to God. But did not drop one piece of incense on that flame. Do you think this is an individual? This type of individual who would have given their soul for God, who understood what was going on, that would not have given up his life for another human being that wanted it as well. This man was prepared. This man was absolutely prepared. And it's not just in the latest moments of their life that we honor them. I mean, those are the ones that we hear about. But we forget the years that they spent in service to God prior, preparing themselves for this. What are we doing? Are we being asked to light incense to Satan or to some false god? No, we're not necessarily being asked to. What we're being asked to do is forget about it. That's what our society wants. That's what all the advertisements, all the noise that surrounds us, all the godless words, all the godless advertisements, all the godless music that is out there, the noise, the chatter, the clutter, all of that creates some sort of a barrier so unless we truly ask for God to be in, he's not. And in this noise, in this chaos that our society has created, where is the peace? It's found in the love that we can offer to our brother. It's found in the peace that we have in taking care of the people who are maybe a little less than, you know, convenient to us at that time. That's where the joy of the Lord is. It's looking at our Lord with love and then looking for him in the people that he brings to us. Finding and sorting through those individuals, giving them our time and attention, giving them our love. It's not easy to do. Brothers and sisters, it is not easy to do because those faces are the same faces that we have been possibly avoiding or possibly trying to get away from. Or possibly trying to sit there and say, what can we do? I'm sure Barlaamus Caesarea wanted to make entire area where he was. I'm sure he wanted to make it all Christian. He could not. What could he do? He could only affect those around him, those that God had given him, and that he had been given. That's all we can do. We're not gonna wake up and be sent to Paris necessarily to do, you know, aftermath therapy for those individuals. Maybe we will, who knows? But not, certainly not today. And most likely not tomorrow. We'll see what opportunity shows up. But there is an individual, there is a person, there is a group of people, whoever they are, that need us right now. First person that needs us to be present is staring us in the mirror. That person needs us to be present to the Lord and present to ourselves, so that we may understand and know who God is and who God wants us to be with. First Him, and then once we are with Him, then our name. Obadiah the prophet, Bartholomew of Caesarea, and that other family of martyrs are witnesses to being with God and then being with others. And that's the message of today. That's the message of our lives right now. We live in a world that desperately needs authentic Christianity, true devotion and love of God. Not this ridiculous militant craziness that's out there. Peace. A peaceful stand for our Lord. A peaceful situation. An understanding. A love. A compassion. It all has to be there. In our sinfulness, sometimes we don't show it all. But we have to recognize that that's our sinfulness. Not the inadequacy of the faith. We can apologize for that. For what we lack. And hope and ask and pray the Holy Spirit to fulfill us. So, to Barlaam, what is our sacrifice? Is it a closed fist to the world? Or is it a hand, or is it a truly unopened heart? Because while his fist was closed, his heart for Christ was wide open. Our hearts must be open, even if we have to close our fists, not in order to give a punch, but rather just to close off and shut from us the things that are going to hurt us. Not the people. So today, we use Barlaam of Caesarea as our example of how to close our fist on the things that will harm us and open our hearts and our lives to our Lord, so that we may be the vessels, as Panagia will be this coming Saturday when we celebrate her feast and enter the temple. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us rise. If you have an opportunity to venerate the icon of putting it at this time. Servants say. to bless, protect, and keep all of you. May the blessing of Panagia be with you as we celebrate your entrance into the temple this Saturday. That service will not be here. It will be in it will be locally at All Saints. I'm sure we'll probably have it in Orcas Ferry or in New England as well, but it's closer. So you are welcome to go to All Saints Weird at 9 o'clock for that service. I will be attending that service in our sister parish of Holy Trinity in North Hills. In North Hills, where Zenith will be present for an ordination. So, just wanted to make sure that you were aware of that, and certainly thank you for being here this evening. We will not be having practices next Wednesday, as I will already be on the road towards my family across the state. So when we meet for practices next, it will be for the beginning of December, the second-ish of December, and then we'll begin a series of services. We'll have St. Barbara on the 4th, St. Silas in the morning on the 5th, St. Nicholas on the 7th. St. Silas is not going to be here. It's going to be, we have a metropolitan who has a feast day, so we get a whole bunch of services, which is good for us to prepare for Christmas, to have all of these services. God bless you, and be here. Will not be here. Be weird for the entrance of the Federal Institute. Thank you.